Sir, I stand to speak on a stated resolution moved by Mr. Bal Gopal. It is very heartening that yesterday we had one statutory resolution to which our leader of the opposition mentioned that the House, it is now realized after a long time that the House can amend the rules presented by the government. Sir, I have chaired the Subordinate Legislation Committee meeting.
I was a member with you.
Yes, you were a member. Chairman. And you know that with your help and support, we found out many departments of the government when they failed to present the rules before the House according to the Act which is being passed by the Parliament. The rule says that within 6 months of the passing of that Act, or making of the Act, the government should come before the Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha to present the rules which they form. Many a time the government has been defaulting. But in this case, sir, in 2004, to improve the airports of our country, a legislation was passed from both the Houses of Parliament. Accordingly, the rules should have been framed within 6 months. According to the rule, which I will quote over here, which is being quoted by our very learned person who has spent a lot of time in studying it, according to Rule 22A, the lessee by an authority can levy a tax or money or surcharge, whatever name you say, from the passengers for development of the airport or modernizing of the airport. So the government passed that, the House passed that law, but the government slept on it. They slept on the rules, they kept on charging the money, they gave the private authorities to develop the airport. Sir, I have traveled many countries all over the world. I used to come back home with a shock. Those days before our two airports and other airports have been developed, I've traveled to many good countries, many small countries, some countries where like Japan, the Narita Airport, or Charles de Gaulle Airport, or Orly Airport at Paris. Beautiful airport. We used to have all the facilities. But we came back to India and we found that our airports were in a chaos. They were dirty. They were not capable to handle the increasing passengers. And we were happy that the government decided, because the government could not afford alone, they came to the House with a privatization proposal with PPP, in which 26% equity should have been paid by the government and 74% equity would come from the private partners. Unfortunately, the government failed in their duty to provide the 26% equity for the development. But the government didn't want to reduce their equity amount, so they did not allow the private parties to increase their equity. That far is correct, sir. But the government should have provided the money from other sources. Unfortunately, the government passed it on to the passengers. The fees which he is mentioned about. First of all, sir, the government should give an explanation to the House why till the matter went to the Supreme Court by some private parties, then only they came to the House with the rules. Why for so many years, from 2004 to 2011, they did not formulate any rules? That's one question I'm going to ask. Secondly, sir, in the newspaper, while they had the provision in the Act to make the rules, to charge the money, They kept on charging the money without any rules, of which the Supreme Court also have mentioned. So now, the newspaper report of the 16th May, it says that, first of all, Delhi Airport, I think, is the world's most expensive airport, because there are two types of fees which they are charging. One, in lieu of the 26% equity which the government should have paid, provided for the development. And secondly, there's another fees which is the upkeep of the airport. Now, as the member mentioned, a lot of land is being allotted to those developing private partners. They have the land, they can get the revenue out of developing the non-aeronautical area. Why they are not doing it? Paucity of time is there, so I'm putting it only in the form of question. The government has to answer all these issues, that why this report is there, that another kind of the fees is being passed. And this fees, this money, is included in the ticket of a person. It gives an impression that the airlines are charging this money. In fact, it's not the airline which is charging the money. The money is going to the government and passing on to the private parties. So government has to explain why this is happening. Secondly, sir, you can charge one-time fees. You cannot charge the embarking passenger as well as disembarking passenger. Can the government and the minister answer to us why there are two types? First of all, there are two different charges the passenger has to give, and within the two, they have to pay once as an embarking passenger, in the other case as a disembarking and embarking passenger. I would like the minister to give the answer to that. Sir, it is fine that today we have got very, very good airport. We are very proud of our airport. There are best facilities available over there. Sometimes I feel when I go to the airport, apart from the conveyor belts, which are very nice, or the counter which are very spread out and people don't have passengers don't have difficulty. Also the checking in and checking out and the security, there are many counters available. The facilities have improved a lot. And the people should pay certain amount of money for the better facility. But sometimes I also feel the airports are looking like a mall, because there are more shops over there than I think in any of the mall in Delhi over there. Now, when the money is coming from those commercialization of the airport, why is it necessary to pass it on to the passenger so much money? There should be some parity for the people. Already the air travel is becoming more and more expensive. Why the government is not taking the responsibility of saving the members this problem? The petrol prices are going and the fare is increasing. I would like the minister to answer these questions. I believe there is another member who is going to speak on this subject. I'm not taking it in detail because the member who moved the motion has taken it upon himself to detail explanation of why he has moved such a motion. I would like the minister to answer these few questions I have put over.
Yes, thank you, madam.